So now I will introduce myself because I'm responsible for the next talk. So I will share my screen, and my talk will be focusing on the tool and the quantification, which is quite complex. Okay, so I'm sharing my screen right now. Okay, so you should be able to see it. So my talk, as I said, my talk will focusing on how to measure digital carbon footprint. Few words on me. So I'm Nicolas, I'm the founder of Greenet.io. And also I'm working with API Days to set up this conference and set up the digital challenge next year. And I'm helping INR Institute regarding best practices in product design. Few words on Greenet. Greenet is a startup, an application to measure and reduce carbon footprint on internet. And this is why I was searching a lot on measurement tool. And this is why I will show you what I saw on the market. So as you know, software is eating the world. Everyone know that since 10 years, but I would say that now software is obese, and this is the problem. And the real question that we need to ask ourselves is, how do we create better software? Emmanuel talked about the return on investment and why we must quantify. And this is exactly what I will show you. Why do we need to measure? And first, I will start by the question, do we really need to measure? And do we really need to measure everything every time? Because you need to take care of measurements, because you will add footprint only by measuring. So sometimes you need to think about, should we measure or not? But for sure, measuring is very important. The problem is that digital services are very complex. And today, unfortunately, there is no perfect tool to measure digital carbon footprint. And this is the bad news in my presentation. The good news is that we need to work for greener IT. So there is a lot of tools and initiatives on the market. Just to summarize, impact is coming from data center, network, and user devices. You know that now. And if we go deeper in detail, the impact can split between manufacturing and usage. And usage is coming from IT resource and non-IT resource. So for example, if you talk about data center, there is always the power usage effectiveness factor that need to be taken into account. Okay, so when you know the electric consumption, you can have let's say an estimation of the carbon footprint thanks to carbon intensity factor, which is based on electricity mix, if you remember the talk this morning by tomorrow startup. So I will spend 10 minutes to show you the tools and the pros and cons of each tools that we can have on the market. And the first one is tools coming from the provider. As we said previously, in fact, there is no so many tools coming from the provider. Data center cloud provider provides some information. So for example, they start to communicate on their global footprint. Google Cloud, Azure, and OVH are doing that. So you can have, let's say, a macro estimation, a rough estimation on the total footprint of your cloud provider data center. Then you need to take care of location. Data center energy or data center carbon is linked to data center location because of the famous electricity mix. So when you select a data center, you need to take care of the performance for sure, but please take care of the location also. And there is few tools to estimate the footprint of your specific infrastructure. For example, if you have only 10 VMs, there is no real tool to measure your impact. Azure did, let's say, launch a business intelligence tool beginning of this year. So it will come, but this is the beginning of the market, on the market. Regarding networks and user device, I do not know real tools on that. So the market needs to evolve on that. And please, if you know tools that will not be presented in this presentation, do not hesitate to share on the stage chat. Okay, there is another tool which is well known. It's EcoIndex and Ecometer. So it's a French tool and created by Green IT Association. EcoIndex gives you an order of magnitude for website, and Ecometer tests eco-design best practices. The good thing is that this tool is very, let's say, good for awareness and focusing only on a website homepage. But the inconvenient is that it's only for website. So at the end of the day, if you have a web application, you will not really measure your impact with EcoIndex. But it's good for website and just to share a score, a label with your colleagues or your client. The second one is the methodology provided by Shift Project, which is called the One Byte model. This is the method I use for Greenet. The methodology will give you an estimation of data center networks and user device impact based on the data transfer and the time spent. So as previously with EcoIndex, Shift Project is a kind of macro estimation because this is based on market research and global consumption of data center. This is not specific to one data center or one provider. So the good point is that it's quite good for awareness, not only on website, but also on application or more complex stuff. And the good thing is that it's linked to data transfer. So you can prove the real figures behind data transfer. The bad thing is that it's not specific enough on specific, provider or specific solution. So it's a good tool to raise awareness for end user, but it's not really usable for software editors. The next one, again, a French one, it's GreenSpector. So GreenSpector is a tool dedicated, really focusing on user device. So they start on user device consumption, they expand to network, and this tool is quite good to see the impact of your application, mobile application on real device. So they launch automated test script to check user journey on end user device. The bad thing is that it's not open source, so you need to pay for that, but it's tailored for software editors. Another good initiative is coming from the US. So Etsy, it's called Etsy Cloud Jewels. So in fact, Etsy, which is a huge cloud user, try to reduce its carbon footprint. So they did an exercise to quantify their carbon footprint. So you can see a link on this slide. And the good thing is that they come to to figures which are called Cloud Jewels coefficient on CPU and storage. So they provide an estimation of energy consumption on CPU and storage. The good thing is that it's a real, a real project from real user, and they provide the methodology and they provide the GitHub project. It's open source. so you can contribute if you want. And the bad thing is that it's only for CPU and storage for the time. So they will improve their tool, but today it's only for CPU and storage. There is an interesting project in France, which is Hublot. The project is called Scaphandre. And the objective of Scaphandre is to measuring power consumption on bare metal and virtual machines. So it's, if you are a developer or DevOps, you know this kind of stuff and you know Prometheus Exporter. So the objective of Scaphandre is to give you power metric directly in your Prometheus or in command line. So the good thing is that it's open source. You can contribute. And they are looking for contributors. So you will be more than welcome. And let's say the bad thing is that it's quite new. The V0.1 was released a few days ago. So it's a very good initiative. And you need to, we need to check it on the future. You have the URL of GitHub in this slide. And you can check the replay after if you need to go to this website. Last slide, and I will move to Boa Vista people. So there is a lot of other initiative, at least locally in France. And I'm part of one, which is Carbon in the Cloud. It's a think tank composed by startups, which collect best practices to measure the cloud infrastructure impact. So we were talking about Claude Jewell's methodology or Scaphandre or stuff like that. We try to understand what is available right now on the market. There is another interesting initiative which started beginning of this year during API Days Challenge, which is Argos. It's an open source tool provided by Marmalab. I will not talk too much on that because Marmalab will have a talk very soon in the second, let's say the next presentation will be made by Marmalab. And I want to spend 5 minutes with Boa Vista because Boa Vista is the think tank working not only on carbon footprint of infrastructure, but also on ISIT department globally. So welcome to Eric. Eric is the CEO of Boa Vista. And Eric, you can present Boa Vista initiative.
Hello, everyone. So my name is Eric Fourboul, and I'm the founder of the Boa Vista project. I'm going to describe right now. So this first slide is to illustrate two things, actually. The first one is, even if it's obvious, it's always important to underline that measurement is a prerequisite for any improvement in any use case, in fact. And the second one is the fact that this project is definitely focusing on the measure, and it's very complementary to other initiatives and other associations such as INR, Emmanuel presented. So, Nicolas, you are the master of the screen. So in fact, the project is born following the few meetings with companies that wanted to measure, in fact, the environmental footprint of their IT system. And at the same time, those companies were encountering a lot of obstacles, and they are kind of complaining about that. And so we decided to launch this initiative. And to be exhaustive and to fully understand the obstacles, we conducted a number of interviews with roughly a dozen companies. So here is a list of the output of the interviews. So I'm not going to read all of them. What it highlights, it's the fact that it's a complex work. And obviously, there is a lack of maturity in the digital industry. It's very difficult to get the data. It's very difficult to understand a complex LCA process. And in the companies themselves, you have some issue in terms of awareness and the digital world, let's say, it's not considered as an environmental issue right now. So this is why we decided to move on. And maybe next slide, please.
Yes.
And following these interviews, in fact, we decided to create this working group with the objective of tackling, in fact, these problems. The key objectives are to develop, based on open source and open data, methodologies, database, and measurement tools. We want to cover the full spectrum. It means that from terminals, devices, to data centers and networks, but also the cloud and all the application that can be hosted in an IT system. It means also to take into account the IT teams who operate the IT system, the buildings, and so on. We want to target a multi-criteria approach, and again, to take all the scopes, scope one, scope two, and scope three, for the full life cycle of the IT system. What is important also to highlight is the fact that we want to leverage, in fact, what has been done already. We're working with the ecosystem in terms of association, academics, and so on, but also with some of the tools that have been presented. So we don't want to redo what has been done. And we want more to aggregate, in fact, both best practices and existing tools with the objective of, leveraging, again, the full spectrum. So we're working with companies that express some needs with experts and so on. Maybe you can move on.
Yes. I'm trying. Okay.
So our first deliverable has been delivered a few days ago. So it's a methodology because we think it's very important to highlight all the steps that has to be tackled when you're doing this kind of measurement. We really think that it's actionable by any companies or any IT engineers. For sure, most of the experts won't learn much from our methodology, but all the people that know very little about this issue will win a lot of time. The idea again is to manage the full cycle. We manage different approaches, both top down and bottom up. It has been built with again different companies such as AXA, La Poste, Crédit Agricole, but also it has been challenged by other companies that are not part of the working group, but also academics like the CNRS or people that are expert in LCA analysis. The goal of that is to be fully open and accessible. So it will be done in, a quarter. We need to challenge more the methodology within the working group. And in Q1 2021, it will be fully open. Okay, and so after this first step, we have definitely a roadmap. Many things are important. So again, we want to focus on measure. So when we are talking about awareness, it's not awareness like INR is managing. It's awareness about just the measure itself. Same with maturity audit. It's definitely necessary to know if you are able to measure. It means that you need to have access to some data, and some companies are not mature enough to be able to measure or to have a reliable measure. We are working a lot on data repository. Right now, many people, many companies are having their own, you know, small data repository. What we want to do is to create a collective protocol to have a shared and valuable data repository for environmental impact of any digital equipment. So it includes, you know, data from most of the main actors like Dell, HP, and so on, but also some data that can be computed by academics or even ourselves. And again, we want also to work on the tools. We want to understand what could be the good arguments for the top management. So we are working right now on managing the economic gain of improving, you know, the digital impact. And it's an ongoing process to work with the ecosystem, because right now a lot of things are moving and in the right direction. That's a good thing. So we need to have a collective action on all those topics.
Okay.
So Nicolas, to conclude, so if you are one of the companies that want to measure and are facing some issue, if you want to have a collective working group on that subject, do not hesitate to contact me, and you will be welcome to join the working group.
Thank you, Eric. So I would say that if you are, let's say, on a management or a process level, you should follow Boa Vista stuff. And if you are a developer or more on technical stuff, I suggest that you follow maybe more Argos or Scaffolder GitHub project, so you can have different perspective on initiative. So let's move on question. We have 1 minute more, less. So yes. Sorry for that. Someone asked if this talk, Grégory asked if this talk will be available in replay. So yes, it will be available in replay, and I will send all the link in this presentation in the chat. Eric, also, if you want to share some link or your email, do not hesitate to share it so people can join you. And there is a question for you, Eric, from Divya. How granular is the calculated figures? Can I have figure per service or per API inside my IT landscape when using Boa Vista?
Yeah, the idea is to have this kind of approach. It means that first we have done a focus on the infrastructure. Infrastructure is data center, network, devices, and so on. And then application, organization, any analysis angle has to be built on top of that. And what is key is to be able to have as much data as attributes when you are doing the measure, to be able to do some data analysis based again on specific applications, specific API, specific organizations, specific business skills. Or any, but first you need to measure the infrastructure footprint, and then to focus on a specific application or digital services.
Yeah. So thank you, Eric, and I think that we will maybe answer to this question during the next presentation. So thank you, Eric, for your time and for your presentation. And I will.
Thank you for the invitation. Anyway.
Yeah, thank you, Eric. So,